Hi, and welcome to this installment of Frank and Mary here in Westborough, the COVID-19 edition. If you haven't seen this show before, my name is Art Bergeron. I'm an elder law attorney. I work at Myrick O'Connell, actually right here in Westborough. But this is not about elder law. This is about my friends Frank and Mary. If you've ever been to one of my presentations, you know that my make-believe couple, Frank and Mary, their goal in life is to live in the house until they die and be buried in the backyard. And if you're in Westborough, that means you want to be here. And the COVID-19 edition of this show was really done out of a desire to help folks like Frank and Mary and you deal with the day-to-day of all of this, especially since a lot of you have been locked up. You were actually stuck in your house all the time. Now, suddenly, things are opening up in bits and pieces, but we're trying to help you figure out how that's working. And a big piece of this is town government and town meeting. So, as you know, my wonderful co-host on the show is Shelby Marshall, who always finds these great guests to talk to and whose information is really current. And Shelby, you've got a great guest for us today with information that is really, really important and current. So who we got?
Excellent. Yes. So our guest today is our town moderator, John Arnold. He's sort of iconic in Westborough, he's sort of secretly, he's sort of like an NFL star to me because of the amazing grace and knowledge he brings to our town meetings. I'm one of those people that loves town meeting. People just roll their eyes. They're like, seriously? I love it. I love every aspect of town meeting, regardless of its length. And John brings to it wit and wisdom. And I'll also say he's also a fellow graduate. We share the same alum of Brown. So maybe that makes me partial. But John has been in service within the town of Westborough since, I think, when he graduated high school. Correct, John?
Yes, I first got appointed to a citizen school advisory council by the school committee when I was a senior in high school back in 1974 or 75. I graduated in 1975, but I believe my appointment letter was from December 74, and I've served on a volunteer position at either state or local government ever since. So it's a long, long time.
And if you're the town moderator, then you're one of those rare people whose major quality is grace under pressure. Mm-hmm. A quality which cannot be overestimated in government, right? Which is just a wonderful thing. So it's very nice to meet you. It's great to have you on.
Yeah. So I, as you said, Arthur, we want to bring current news and information to folks in Westborough. So we're taping this show on a Wednesday. It'll be ready on Friday. And it's important because our town meeting is scheduled to take place, fingers crossed and COVID God willing, on Saturday, the 20th of June. And so John's here to talk to us about not only his role as town moderator and what does that mean, but really to let the residents know what is that town meeting experience going to be like. And it's been a very thoughtful process between John and our town clerk, who's obviously a critical role in any sort of voting or public meetings, as well as with the Board of Health. So, John, take it away. Talk to us about town meeting.
Sure. Well, town meeting in general, first of all, just sort of set the stage a little bit. One of the interesting things about town meeting, which is sort of a unique governmental structure in New England, I won't go into the full history lesson, but there's a lot of us who grow up thinking I have to cajole or convince some elected representative to essentially try to vote my interests or espouse, the things that I care about. An interesting thing about Westborough, which is one of the 100 or so open town meeting towns in Massachusetts, means that every registered voter can attend open town meeting and they can act as their own citizen legislator. So if you've always wanted to sort of put on an air of self-importance, you can go to town meeting and say, look at me, I'm a legislator. Because while we have the selectman and the town manager as the executive branch of government, so if you think of that as essentially the governor's slice of the state government or the presidential slice of the federal government. The open town meeting is our legislature. So whereas in the state government, we have a state House of Representatives and a state Senate. And in Washington, D.C., we have our House of Representatives and our federal Senate, which is sort of a bicameral setup. In town meeting, the town meeting is the unique legislative body. And so anything and everything having to do with things like raising and appropriating money, allocating resources through budgets, setting up the town's bylaws, which are our own bylaws that sort of specialize the state and federal bylaws we have, or our zoning. All of those things are required to come before town meeting in our form of government and all need a positive vote. Some things majority, some things two-thirds. But an important thing is to say, in an open town meeting town, you're not obligated to have to explain your vote. You're not obligated to have to cajole someone else to vote your conscience. You can attend and you can vote your own conscience.
And can I just add one thing to that? Another, I'm saying this not as a lawyer, one of the interesting aspects of town meeting is that while in general, governments are constrained by procedure, that if you vote something out of a city council, if you vote something even at the state level, there are a set of rules that people have to play by, and otherwise things can be challenged because they're procedurally defective. There is a lot of case law that indicates that when town meeting is going, what happens at town meeting not only stays at town meeting, but it just is official by virtue of the fact that the town has done it that way. And the moderator is really regarded as an important determinant of all of that stuff. And if the moderator said it was okay, in many, many, many cases, it's simply okay. So you really, going to John's point, you really are there as it's like a your Greek, you know, Athenian model. You're kind of all showing up and you're making laws for yourself. It's a wonderful thing. I mean, there's a lot of criticism about it, but when done well, it's really a wonderful thing.
Yeah, thanks. And another point that I wanted to make is that my role as moderator, it really comes into two facets. The main one, the most visible role that people see is that I am essentially the chief parliamentarian and I preside over and sort of keep the town meeting moving. And I've tried throughout my tenure as moderator, try to talk to people and find ways to balance having it efficient, but also making sure that it retains this deliberative nature. The deliberative nature is important because many people say, like, well, why can't we just, you know, put all the warrant articles on a ballot and just vote yes or no? And going back to the history of the way legislative bodies work and the reason why you have to be present in voting is the legal term at a town meeting, is that it's not just a here's a question, let's vote up or down, but there's a deliberative process where people can say, like, well, I like most of it, but I don't like this part. How about we make a motion to amend that part? And if you've been to a town meeting or watch it, you've seen, you know, the ebb and flow and people cajole into what I think almost always turns into the right compromise for the people of the town at that moment in time. So that's the most visible part. And I'll just quickly just say the other part of my job is as sort of the ceremonial head of the legislative body. I appoint the 9-member advisory finance committee, which are 9 voters in town. And their job is to essentially make recommendations to the town meeting where they do a deeper dive than most people can. And it's one of our checks and balances that essentially says, you know, there will be articles and ideas and motions put before a town meeting, and we have 9 voters and striving to represent geographic and, you know, and gender, and keep on trying to work on ethnic diversity as well. Have those people do a deep dive, and then they report to the town meeting to say, we've looked into this and here's what we think. And it's an important way of having a check and balance that things, as I say, the grand compromise is almost always right. The wisdom of town meeting is very, very good.
And John does an amazing job to, as parliamentarian, to really, I think, allow voices to be heard. It's pretty magical to watch it. So this is sort of my plug, that if you've never been to town meeting, this one's going to be a great one to come to. We hope. It's going to be shorter by its construct because we recognize concerns around COVID-19 and gathering together in an indoor space where we will be having town meeting. Although we did contemplate having it outside, but because of acoustical concerns and the ability to see slides and that sort of thing, we determined that wasn't going to be a good fit. So we've consolidated how many articles, there's a recommendation to pass over a number of them, and then we'll move to the October town meeting when we have a special town meeting. So John, I guess, you know, talk to us a little bit about what could a town meeting goer, first time or otherwise, and maybe particularly to those who have experienced town meeting, what can they expect at this town meeting?
Yeah, well, as you can imagine, these are challenging times, and this town meeting will probably be unlike any other town meeting you've ever been to, mostly because regardless, outside, inside, or whatever, we're still, I mean, the goal is, and I've been relying on, you know, lots of interaction with the Board of Health and Selectmen to make sure that we're providing as safe an environment as possible. So whether if you've been to a town meeting in the past, you're used to, you know, almost always meeting in the high school auditorium, people sort of, you know, meander in, people sit close to their friends, you know, people have chit chat while we're getting ready to start. This time, the recommendation from the Board of Health and the plan that we've gone over is that everything is going to be socially distanced, you know, for because it's necessary. The last thing we would want would be to, you know, sort of have the town meeting turn into one of these super spreader events. So the first thing is, you know, bring your mask. It's gonna seem silly, but it's better than getting sick from what I hear of the few people whose families have experienced it. So, and what we're trying to do is to try people have be as distant and as they can be. So if you've been to town meeting, you know you typically enter through the upper parking lot at the high school, and you go straight through the doors and you go downstairs. And if in the past you've enjoyed the cookies or the bottles of water from the women's club, well, it's going to be different this year. There's no congregation. Unfortunately, there's not going to be any sort of selling of food. So if you can bring some bottled water with a cap, please bring some bottled water. If you can make a snack that you think you can eat without leaving too many crumbs behind for the high school's custodians, please do. But what we're going to do is we're going to try to have as much of the line to check in outside have the line as outside as possible. And that's so people, you know, don't have to breathe the inside air for any longer than they have to. So we're planning on having taped off a line on the there's a handicapped walkway that goes from that upper where instead of going to the doors you'd normally go in, you turn to your left and there's a winding, you know, ADA accessible pathway down to a door that gets us on the main on the main level where the entrance to the gym and the auditorium is. So again, you'll be 6 feet apart, you know, and we will allow couples who have been cohabitating without masks to act as what I'm calling a family unit, whether they're technically a family or not. We're not going to quibble. So they may stay close by, but we're going to ask everyone to have masks on unless there's a compelling reason. And then you will be called and go to one of the tables where there will likely be a plexiglass shield between you and the town clerk staff to check you in. When you're checked in, you will be asked to stay 6 or more feet apart while you walk down the hallway, and there will be hopefully volunteers there to guide you. And what we're going to do is the largest capacity room we have in town is the large Bud Fisher gym at the high school. That's 110 feet by 100 feet, so it's 11,000 square feet. And we're going to have separated out little grids of, let me just get my notes here, grids of approximately 114 spaces that can hold 1, 2, 3 people. There'll be a few that could hold 4, but that's only people that you are comfortable with being as your family unit. So the idea is we can probably get the usual size of people who show up to a town meeting in the large gym. So there will be the town clerk, myself, the selectmen, the finance city, and the finance committee and the school committee, all physically distant, just like you. Nobody gets special treatment. I'll be wearing a mask as much as possible unless there's audio problems. And if I have to take mine off, there is going to be a plexiglass screen in front of me. But we did want to make special considerations for the elderly or for people with medical conditions who absolutely need the padded chairs or the armrest to get up and down. So we'll probably be opening up either being able to email or call the town clerk or the COVID hotline to request one of the limited seats in the auditorium. The auditorium, we believe, can hold about 70 to 90 people, again, physically distant. So it's going to be like a physically distant wedding. Unlike the past where you just get to cluster and sit in the rooms next to the people you want, we're going to ask people to be seated where we're going to try to load people toward the front first and toward the back. So you have to walk past as few people as possible. And so as few people have to walk past you as possible. This is both in the auditorium and in the gym. And we will have at least audio connections because the law requires a multiple room town meeting to have at least audio connections. There will be a moderator or a deputy moderator and a clerk or an assistant clerk in each of the rooms to coordinate so everybody gets to see and hear. And I'll try to fairly balance the people who want to speak, and we'll take votes from everywhere. And we're going to try to set up a separate room, either a small classroom or the library, for people who either can't wear a mask or who don't want to wear a mask. So we are strongly encouraging people to wear masks, but if somebody just can't or is adamantly opposed to wearing a mask, we will likely put those people in a physically distant room, physically distant from each other, where they will be able to sit, and they will also have a deputy moderator and a town clerk's assistant, and they will also be able to hear, and if we can get the TV gizmos set up, be able to see. And then the meeting will run as close to normal as possible, where we're going to try to streamline things along. We're going to try to ask people to keep their remarks shorter. I'm going to have a shorter lease than usual. And as Shelby mentioned, to cut the length of the meeting down because of the uncertainty of some of the revenues coming in from the state or from the town, or some things that have just been decided that the selectmen or others have agreed that they think it's better to put off and not do now. Right as soon as we do the Pledge of Allegiance and my abbreviated preamble to get things going because of the COVID-19, I'm expecting that we're going to entertain a motion to have the town vote to essentially pass over a number of articles that will be dealt with at a meeting. And then once we start, it's going to be very similar. We'll take a few we'll say what the motions are. We will deliberate. We will provide fair and balanced deliberation, though trying to keep speeches and presentations short. And then we're just going to go. And the idea is bring your snacks, bring your water. Once we load the room, if you have to leave, leave. But we're not planning on doing a dinner break. We're going to start at noon. Remember, we normally start at 1. We're going to start at noon. And we're hoping to be done by 5 or 6. So we don't have to take a break, sanitize the chairs, and bring everybody back and do the whole thing again. So I know that was a long description, but that's sort of what you should expect.
Can I just ask a couple questions?
Oh, yeah.
So three questions. One, I had thought, now once again, forgive me for not being, you know, really current with this stuff. I had thought that there was some kind of cap on the size of public gatherings, but it's sounding like you're more than that, and is that an issue? That's the first question.
Yeah, it all goes back. I'll just answer one at a time. Yeah, just so people remember. Yes. So the question is, hey, how are we getting away with this? Because it's more than 10 people. Well, if you remember, I said the purpose of town meeting is we are a legislative body, and the governor's state of emergency and the regulations that went into place specifically excluded legislative bodies. So that's why we can legally go ahead. But out of an abundance of caution, we're relying on the Board of Health and the health director to tell us whether the plans we have in place seem to be adequate to protect the public safety.
So the second question is kind of not on the big side, but on the small side of the meeting. So it seems to me that I had read something about a reduced quorum requirement in order to make sure that these meetings could advance. In case nobody showed up, right?
That's right,
or practically nobody.
Yeah, so and again, we're an interesting case. Yes, so there was a law passed that essentially said, because some towns have like a 200 or a 400 person quorum, and of course some towns either don't have the capacity or they don't think that many people are going to show up. Westborough, a number of years ago, probably at least 10 to 15 years ago, has zero quorum for the annual town meeting. And for our regularly scheduled special town meeting in October. And that was essentially so we didn't have to wait to start the proceedings until we had 100 people in the room. So we're encouraging everybody get there early, get seated, but we can actually start the meeting as soon as we're all ready to go.
That's great. Now, final question. So are people who go going to be able to get like a special bumper sticker? Like I survived the Westborough Town Meeting of 2020. Because they're going to be able to give this to their grandchildren. Like, I made it. I didn't die.
Good idea.
I went to this town meeting.
For my own family.
He really has one. He's pulling it out. I can't believe it.
Yeah, for the town archives, I mean, for those of you who haven't seen it, when I've postponed the town, I know you can't read it, when I've postponed the town meeting now three times, I had to issue a formal declaration of why I was postponing it, and to post it. So I've got a few originals, signed originals, you know, that we'll be putting up on eBay. Just kidding. But actually, interesting you mentioned that. What I've been working with the town clerk is
no, I thought you had to sign them while you were there. Won't there be a table and you can just like sign these? No.
Yeah. But anyway, yes. Yeah, so anyway, good point. So those of you who've been to town meeting know in the past we've used electronic voting, and that's hurried things along. However, there's so much uncertainty this year, and we're not sure if we're going to need two rooms, three rooms, or whatever, and it costs a lot of money for our electronic voting vendor to show up and, you know, set up the network in two rooms or three rooms. We've decided that we're going to save the town money by not having electronic voting, and I don't have a sample, but we're probably going to go to a half-size piece of paper on a bright color that the town clerk will decide. So you're going to get a half-size piece of paper. And Wendy, the town clerk, Wendy Nickel, and I have actually been thinking of trying to turn the voting slip into a collectible by having a special Westborough COVID-19 June town meeting as you can take home with you. So you'll need to use it. You'll need to leave it in one piece till you're done. But I'm hoping that that some people will take that as, hey, I was there that crazy day when we had to wear masks and sit six or 7 feet apart.
Yeah, so I know we're lots of smiles. I hope everyone understands the detail in which John and team have really gone to ensure accessibility and safety to this meeting for all. There's been a lot of back and forth and dialogue as to do we have it, do we not have it? We don't want to make sure we don't disenfranchise anyone, that everyone feels comfortable in coming, or as many people feel comfortable as coming as possible, given all the precautions. So I want to assure everyone that it will be safe. It's being taken seriously. John has worked closely with the Board of Health. We've got maps of X's of where seats are going to be. John, you didn't mention, but I will for you. Usually we pass around microphones, you know, where people can speak. So they're going to use a boom microphone. So it will be kind of above so someone can talk. You don't have to touch it. For those who can't get up actually physically walk, or that's a challenge for them to walk to the microphone, I think there's a proposal for they could jot down their question on a card, give it to John, and he could read, announce the name of the person who's asking the question, and he would read the question for the legislative body. So yeah. I think we've covered so many different aspects of this, the what ifs, that it's going to be a great meeting, and it will be one to say I survived.
Yeah, and just one other point. I know we're running low on time. I just want to point out, once the meeting starts, it is the voters' meeting. There is I'm chief parliamentarian. One of the key rules of when you run meetings in parliamentary procedure, as we do, is if at any time somebody has a procedural question, or in this case, especially a health or safety question, all you have to do is call out point of order, and that can stop the meeting in its tracks. And so if people don't feel safe or have a question or say something's going on, there is an opportunity for people to do that. And since it's the people's meeting, it is the people who will finally decide not only what they vote, but is the meeting safe to proceed and how are we doing? And we will be, and I'll try to make time to check in on that without slowing down the meeting. I'll try to make sure that people are comfortable, that they've had their questions asked and know what's going on. I always try to turn town meeting into a teaching moment. And this year, especially, we'll all be learning together.
This is like such a wonderful testament to democracy to people just paying attention, people in community really paying attention to taking care of each other, which is just wonderful. Yeah. It's just wonderful. This has been really special. Thanks for doing this. I'm sorry that I won't be able to get one of those collectibles.
Well, right? we'll get you a copy.
I'm gonna save one for you. We know they're not valid anymore.
Shelby,
hey, John, in all seriousness, make sure you save maybe some original copies and get them over to Tony Vaver so that they can become part of the town's archives.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, I'm saving my declarations as well.
So. Yeah, good.
So thank you. Thank you very much, John. Shelby, thanks again. You always find these wonderful people, and I think it's informative. I hope people have enjoyed these shows. We try to bring on not only good informative guests, but entertaining guests. This guy, this definitely qualifies,
awesome?
Right?
So
you have to go to town meeting just to see him, just
That's
to
right.
see him in action.
And it's free.
And you get a collectible. And you get a collectible. So we hope you've enjoyed this. And we'll see you on the next installment of Frank and Mary here in Westborough, the COVID-19 edition. And have a wonderful time, all of you, at town meeting. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.